I'm Catherine Ross, and I'm here live from the floor of the NYC with Jim Cramer. Jim, what's top of mind for you this morning?
Well, top of mind is that at 3:30 last night, the Chinese put out the word that there's some good news in coronavirus. Callan did say that the rate of coronavirus illnesses detected had gone down a little bit. That's what would mean at the end of it. I don't know. But you get the futures go down off of a Carnival cruise line, 10 people on a boat off of Yokohama, sends the futures down. And then the Chinese come in again, as they have for the last 3 days, with good news and changes and stimulus. And they're the ones behind, not the U.S., not the Fed, but the Chinese come in every day with something good. And it works.
Speaking of the coronavirus, a lot of earnings reports that I've seen have mentioned the coronavirus, and that makes me wonder, is it going to be the make or break moment for companies, for Ford Gardens?
It hasn't been. As a matter of fact, you have stocks that it doesn't even, it's just a glancing blow. Nike was down $1.50 on the news, and then it comes right back. Disney down a little, down $3, and then comes right back. So people are just asterisking it, saying that it's a temporary headwind.
Now let's switch gears and talk about the State of the Union. Last night, President Trump came off as being very bullish, and I have to ask, is his bullish motivation enough to keep this rally going?
Yes. No. I mean, it's very positive. I mean, look, what he's talking about is the reminder that employment is strong, and employment is directly correlated with the stock market. $12 trillion in gains from the stock market. So it's all pretty serious. It's all very positive. Now, hate him or like him, it's positive.
Let's switch gears. Let's talk about Disney, which is our real money stock of the day. I have to ask, is Disney Plus, because Bob Iger last night on the call just kept saying original content, original content, original content, is Disney Plus kind of stealing Netflix's plans right out from under?
Plenty of room for both. I do think that the Disney Plus numbers were incredible. They made it so you didn't think about ESPN decline anymore, so he finally pulled it off. Ben Swinburne over at Morgan Stanley saying the numbers could double. So Disney, which is Action Alert's position, stay long.
Let's end with by talking about Macy's, which has a very expensive restructuring plan going to be put into place.
You know, they had to do it. What I'm surprised about is that they had that many people in corporate. They slashed 10%, 2,000. They're obviously way too heavy corporate, and they needed to make changes, and this cost takeout could be very positive. But at the same time, as Matthew Boss says at JP Morgan, there's still no growth. So you can't cut your way into growth.
Do you think that Amazon, the Death Star, as you've referred to it before, had anything to do with it?
Absolutely. I mean, I think that anything brick and mortar is up against Amazon because they're in bad malls, and bad malls are dead weight loss.
All right, and Jim does have his Action Alerts Plus members only monthly call tomorrow at 11:30 a.m., so you got to tune in for that. Jim, thanks for joining us today.
Sure.
Guys, thanks for tuning in. We are now heading over to our Action Alerts Plus daily rundown show over on actionalertsplus.com. I'm Catherine Ross, and we'll see you tomorrow.